I want you all to understand that those moments when you're feeling anxious or insecure, those moments when you're not sure you can reach that next level, those are the moments when you shape yourself into who you want to be. All right? That's actually proven by science and research that shows that when you think hard about something or you struggle to solve a problem, whether it's math or science or a problem in life, your brain is actually growing. You're actually becoming smarter because of that struggle. So embrace it. Relish those moments. Those are the moments when you've got to tell yourself to reach higher. And that's really my message to all of you today. You have come so far. You've climbed so high to get here. But you have got to keep reaching higher.
One thing always remain the same. Once you set your goals, always aim higher. I have to say that hard work and dedication are the cornerstones of success. And if you believe in yourself, even when others are doubting you and society is pushing you down, it's so important to always have that self-belief in yourself. I stand here and I can tell you, I know what it's like to be overlooked as a woman, as a black woman, but I never let anyone define my potential by my gender or my color. I continue to raise my voice in hopes of breaking barriers and making it easier for those coming up after me. And one thing that I truly, truly believe in is that the success does not define a person. It's how successful you can be after you fall. A lot of people that truly inspire me are those not who are wildly successful, but those who are wildly successful after they fell, and then they came back to be super successful again. And that's what, for me, fuels a successful brand and a person.
But there's another world too, and it's a far more important one. It's the world that dwells inside of us. It's the world that includes our heart, our soul, our hopes, our fears, and our dreams, along with the one thing that ultimately controls them all, our mind. Because once you take control of the world within, the world outside of you becomes your oyster. It becomes a black canvas upon which you can paint anything, from a simple finger painting to the Mona Lisa. What's more, the only way you can change the outside world is by changing the world inside of you. And how do you do that? It's to take control of your mind. Nurture your mind, feed it, challenge it, expand it, and ultimately master it. It's rarely exciting, and it's a dull and tedious exercise, but you must do it. And when you learn to control your mind and learn to discipline yourself to do the things your mind and conscience tell you to do, you can gain mastery over everything else. Other than, of course, what God has in store for you.